Hey guys, it's Sandeep from Driverless, and in this video we'll be taking a look at the review of the HP Envy x360 powered by the latest 11th gen Tiger Lake Intel Core i7 processor. And before we get this started, please do make sure to hit the subscribe button and also turn on notifications to avoid missing any videos from us in the future. Now let's begin. The Envy x360 is available in both 13 and 15 inch variants, and we have the more portable 13 inch variant, and our config comes with an Intel 11th gen Tiger Lake 1165 G7 i7 processor, Intel Xe graphics, 16 GB of RAM and a 512 GB NVMe SSD. The price for this variant is an MRP of ₹99,999. Now this HP laptop is a convertible, which means that it can convert into your tablet as well as be used in several different positions based on your requirement. As a laptop, the keyboard remains active until you go beyond the 180 degree angle for the hinge, after which the laptop automatically disables the keyboard as well as enables auto rotate for your tablet mode. You get a stylus in the box, which is pretty cool as it charges over USB Type-C, and also comes with a nice design which hides the charging port and has a red circular ring at the top to indicate the charge status. At 1.32 kilograms, the Envy 13 x360 is very light and portable, and the convertible functionality only adds to its versatility and is around 15 mm thick at its thickest point in its wedge-shaped design. The laptop is light enough to be carried around with ease, but also doesn't feel like they've compromised on build quality, as it feels robust and premium. It feels solidly built and there are no creaks anywhere. The keyboard is a chiclet style one, but it provided a better typing experience than I expected thanks to the good key travel and proper spacing and size of the keys. The layout too isn't too far away from a regular desktop 10 keyless keyboard, and there's no deck flex either despite the light design. In fact, there's no flex on the chassis, and the display portion has a very slight flex, which is only seen if you actually try to put much pressure. The backlight is in white and is pretty even, and you can choose two different levels of backlighting. The mousepad is fairly large for the size, but I felt it to be a bit disappointing compared to the keyboard, as it is a plastic one and doesn't feel as smooth or easy to use and navigate like a typical glass trackpad. Perhaps HP thought that the touchscreen ability would mean that most people would resort to that instead of solely relying on the trackpad. Speaking of which, the touch input is quite nice and useful, especially for photo editing, which this can handle easily, and we'll speak about it later on in the review. The Envy supports Windows Hello and uses the fingerprint scanner that's neatly tucked in the keyboard between the cursor and Alt keys, and the fingerprint scanner is pretty fast and accurate. The display is a 13.3 inch Full HD 1920x1080p IPS panel with a max brightness of 400 nits. The display is sharp, has good contrast as well as brightness, and it performs well in every situation, albeit with higher reflections than we'd like, especially in direct sunlight situations, owing to the highly glossy display. Despite the slim profile, they managed to pack in pretty good connectivity options. You get a micro SD card reader on the right, as well as a USB Type-C, an audio jack on the left, and two USB Type-A ports on either side. The Type-C port is a Thunderbolt 4 port, which is supported courtesy of the Intel 11th Gen i7 CPU inside it, and allows for transfer of speeds up to 40 gigabits per second, as well as support for 5K display. Speaking of audio, you get a pair of B&O speakers, and they sound good in terms of quality and have fairly good depth and bass, however they do not have great loudness. There's a 720p webcam above the display in the center, and this is a decent one in terms of quality. Nothing much to brag about quality wise, but the good thing is that you get a physical shutter to cover the camera for added privacy when you want to disable it, and you can disable the microphone as well when it's not in use to prevent other apps from gaining access without your knowledge. The storage is a Samsung NVMe SSD, which is rated for a max read speed of 3500 MB per second and a write speed of 2900 MB per second, and our test showed that it performed as good if not slightly better than promised, and is one of the best SSDs that you can get on a laptop currently. The 16 GB of RAM is soldered, so in case you were thinking of getting the 8 GB and then upgrading later, we'd suggest spending that extra amount to get the 16 GB variant. And in terms of performance, although this would most likely be used for productivity and multimedia consumption, we did try to push it to its limits by doing photo and video editing in 4K, and in this, the Intel 11th Gen i7 1165 G7 CPU performed very well and much better than some other laptops that I tested alongside it. While the lack of a dedicated GPU means that this wouldn't be your first choice if you're a creator, I didn't expect it to perform as well as it did. The Intel Iris Xe graphics performs surprisingly well, especially on a slim and light productivity machine such as this. Scrubbing through a timeline with video editing was pretty quick thanks to the fast storage, and the CPU and Intel Iris Xe graphics handled it nicely with quick export times as well. If your use is primarily productivity but needs some creativity flowing at times, this can definitely help do the task, but make sure you go for the 16GB variant like we mentioned earlier. The laptop supports Wi-Fi 6 via the Intel Wi-Fi 6 card and got consistent results in our speed test, and the range was also pretty good. It has Bluetooth 5, which we use to connect to various Bluetooth headphones and TWS, and all perform well, although the connectivity process isn't the smoothest on a Windows laptop due to the clunky UI. The laptop comes with a proprietary port on the right, which supports up to 65 watts of power, but the great thing is that it can also charge over the Type-C port, so if you have a powerful enough charger, you can make use of that and leave your stock charger at home. The laptop comes with a 51 Wh battery that doesn't sound like a large capacity, but this is where the 11th gen Intel i7 chipset comes in play with good efficiency, which manages to give battery life north of 10 hours in our daily use cases. And one of the reasons behind this is the fact that the laptop is part of the Intel Evo platform, where there are a few minimum requirements that any laptop that is part of this platform should meet. Simply put, the Intel Evo platform means that Intel makes sure that manufacturers do whatever is possible to improve the end user experience. Take Instant Wake, for example, where you no longer need to spend time waiting for your computer to be ready when you want to get work done or have ideas flowing. Better battery life means that you have less to worry about needing a charger or searching for a charging socket whenever you enter a new room, and even if you do require to use a charger, the fast charging functionality means that your work isn't dictated by charging ports anymore, and that allows you to be more flexible and free. Intel also has several mandates for the platform, including the need to bundle fast Wi-Fi 6 internet connectivity, Thunderbolt 4, fast storage drives, sleek design, high quality audio, and much more. Intel mandates that laptops need to wake up from sleep in less than a second, have 9 hours or more of battery from a Full HD display on a single charge, and provide 4 hours or more of usage from just 30 minutes of charge on a Full HD display, and more. In short, Intel's Evo platform makes sure that your laptop is faster, more reliable, and more flexible than ever before, so you can work anywhere and everywhere hassle-free. I do wish that HP focused on a few other issues like the trackpad, the glossiness of the display, etc., but none of these are actually deal breakers for the target audience. It does everything the target audience wants and then some more. And being the first time that I tried the Envy X360, I didn't know what to expect exactly. I was almost certain that I wouldn't be able to handle complex photo or video editing, but I was pleasantly surprised that the Intel 11th Gen 1165 G7 Intel i7 chipset was able to handle easily 4K video editing, which makes this an ultrabook that can actually serve creators as well as office and education users. Thanks for watching this video. We'll leave a purchase link in the description below in case you want to purchase the laptop. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you again in the next one.